New insights into the stratigraphic setting of Paleozoic to Miocene deposits. This course is brought to you by Gilad James Mystery School. Learn more at giladjames.com. Introduction. This is the introductory lecture of the course New Insights into the Stratigraphic Setting of Paleozoic to Miocene Deposits, Case Studies from the Persian Gulf, Peninsular Malaysia and Southeastern Pyrenees. In this lecture, the research themes studied in this course have been introduced referring to the paleoecological and facies analysis techniques and methodologies, pertaining, in particular, an Oligo-Miocene carbonate succession of the Persian Gulf, Asmari Formation, the chemostratigraphy of Paleozoic carbonates of Peninsular Malaysia through the integration of stratigraphic, sedimentologic, and geochemical data, and the chronostratigraphy of a small ice-dammed paleolake in Andorra, applying the FFT, fast Fourier transform, analysis, resulting in sixth-order stratigraphic cycles, which have outlined the occurrence of glacially controlled system tracts and unconformities. The topic of the Asmari Formation and its depositional environments has been deeply studied. Referring to its biostratigraphy, it was earlier outlined in the 1960s based on unpublished reports. The application of isotopic stratigraphy has later proved that the sediments ascribed to the Miocene Aquitanian are, in fact, late Oligocene, Chadian in age. This was proved by the application of SR isotope stratigraphy to quartz sections from 10 Iranian oil fields and 14 outcrop sections, within the framework of a high-resolution sequence stratigraphy study down to fourth-order cycles. The Chadian/Aquitanian boundary is marked by a major faunal turnover, with the general extinction of Archaeus species and Mygypsonoids complinatus. The age interpretation of the early, unpublished zonations has needed a deep revision and the establishment of an updated biozonation. The new zonation and the stratigraphic ranges of selected key species have been presented by Larson et al., 2009. The isotopic stratigraphy based on strontium has constrained the stratigraphic setting of the Asmari Formation. This formation, consisting of approximately 400 meters of cyclic platform limestones and dolostones, with subordinate intervals of sandstones and shales, has been studied in the subsurface at several oil fields and in an outcrop section. The methods of SR isotope stratigraphy is suitable for dating these strata because of the fast rate of marine strontium ratio during the depositional processes, roughly 32 to 18 mi. The profiles of age against depth in the four areas have shown a decrease from higher accumulation rates in the lower Asmari to lower rates in the middle upper part of the formation. These changes reflect the dynamics of platform progradation, from early deposition along relatively high accommodation margin to slope settings and then, to conditions of lower accommodation on the shelf top. The ages of the sequence boundaries have been estimated from the age depth profiles at each locality, providing a framework for stratigraphic correlation. The depositional sequences have an average duration of 1 to 3 mi, whereas the component cycles represent average time intervals of 100 to 300 ky. On the other side, the Kinta limestones have been matter of previous studies, mainly referring to the depositional environments. In the Kinta Valley, they are composed of medium to dark gray, fine-grained, thinly bedded limestones, with preserved bedding planes and slump depositional features. The faunal content is quite scarce, except that some conodont faunas, while a high organic content is suggested from the dark color of the deposits. The sedimentological and facies analysis has suggested the occurrence of low-energy, slope environment hosting the deposition of the Kinta limestones. The high organic content coupled with the lacking of benthic fauna has indicated a low oxygen setting. On the other side, the Kinta limestones were dominated by mudstones interlayered with bedded cherts and perhaps were deposited in a slope environment with a significant contribution of pelagic deposits. The geological evolution of the Kinta Valley has been recently outlined as characterized by both deposition and structural deformation. During the Devonian, the deposition started, composed of alternating sandstones and mudstones, followed in the Carboniferous by fine-grained shales, which are, in turn, overlain by Permian limestones. During the Triassic early Jurassic, the intrusion of granites cut previously deposited carbonate deposits. The whole deposits are overlain by quaternary alluvial deposits. An early compressional event and a late extensional event have been distinguished. Folding and thrusting occurred during the compression, also controlling the granitic intrusion, which was fractured due to compressional deformation. The extensional tectonic event resulted from the individuation of normal faults, controlling the present-day drainage network evident from DIM analysis. A high-resolution biostratigraphy of the Kinta limestones has been later proposed based on conodont sampled in three boreholes, composed of carbonate mudstones with shales and siltstones. 9 diagnostic conodont genera and 28 age diagnostic conodont species have been identified. In particular, Pseudopolygnathus triangulus triangulus and Declinognathidus noduliferus noduli freshave indicated that the successions, pertaining to the Kinta limestones, range in age from the Upper Devonian to the Upper Carboniferous. Moreover, these data have provided clues to the Paleotethys paleogeographic reconstruction and paleo-depositional conditions. Recently, the deformational styles and the structural history of the Paleozoic limestones of the Kinta Valley have been defined by using remote sensing mapping, outcrop samples, and hand specimens. An early extensional event has been identified, as marked from normal faults, while a compressional event was indicated by a set of strike-slip faults. The geologic evolution has been interpreted as an intrabasinal extension during Permo-Triassic times, which was followed by a late Miocene to Quaternary tectonic uplift. The high-resolution chronostratigraphy of the paleolakes is a main research topic, which has been deeply studied by several authors. In particular, the Ibate paleolake has shown a distal lacustrine environment with low oxygen conditions in its bottom waters. The occurrence of anachalosidites eocenonicusp. November, combined with the lacking of Stesiplinites nativensis, indicates a late Santonian age for the paleolake, ca. 84 Ma. This age is constrained by the occurrence of carbonized sclerites that are associated with the Great Santonian Wildfire recorded in coeval marine offshore strata of the Campos and Santos basins. The palynological content, coupled with the occurrence of rhythmic deposits, have indicated a late Santonian age of these deposits. The age assignment is based on palynostratigraphic relationships established from a reliable biostratigraphic framework, based on integration of palynological and biostratigraphic data. On the other side, the Kaidim Lake represents an excellent example in order to study the interplay of climatic and tectonic controls on continental saline lakes. Two main events of increase of salinity have been controlled by the climate during the late Eocene since the Oligocene, while tectonic events have controlled the migration of the saline centers. The accumulation of halites and their preservation were the result of a coupled control by active tectonism, in order to provide accommodation space and trigger a rapid subsidence. The Navamuno peat bog system, located in western Spain, has been deeply studied. During the late Pleistocene, it was dammed by the Cuerpo de Hombre glacier and was fed by lateral meltwaters. This depression was then filled by glacial-lacustrine deposits. During the Holocene, its geologic evolution was controlled by a fluvial plain, controlling the episodes of shallow pond/peat bog sedimentation. An age model was constructed based on radiocarbon dating, allowing to interpret the environmental changes during the late glacial and the post-glacial. Another representative paleolake is the Tongre Yumko, represented by a wide saline paleolake located on the Tibetan Plateau, which has been recently studied as a valuable example in order to reconstruct the climatic variations. Micropaleontologic and sedimentologic data have been integrated with isotopic stratigraphy. Integrated stratigraphic information has allowed to reconstruct the geologic evolution of the paleolake during the last 17 KY. The lake level was low at 17 KY BP, followed by a high stent phase at 8 to 9 KY BP. Since 2.5 KY, the paleolake remained stable regarding its level, with a short high stent low stent cycle around 2 KY. These changes have been considered as good hints of paleoclimatic conditions in order to refine the paleoclimatic models in this area. In this course, different case studies have been presented, respectively, located in the Persian Gulf, in the Peninsular Malaysia, and in the Andorra. To this aim, it should be useful to clarify their geological structure to put the studied cases in a proper geological setting. The Persian Gulf is represented by an enclosed sea, limited from the Western Arabian platform to the south and by the Zagros Fold and Thrust Belt to the northeast.